Hello, this is Davide Biocchi from Italy, and we are in this midweek edition of our appointment with the intermarket situation connected to different asset classes. So, first of all, let's see the situation connected to the euro dollar. Easily, we can see in the chart that we have support and resistances. So, after 2 months around this level, between 1.08 and 1.010, fast movement here, okay. Not reach the target that we can assume as 1.15, but more or less we created with this movement a clear resistance here, a little bit over 1.14, and this one that is 1.1160. So this is the situation more or less for the euro dollar. We can expect the market to raise and to overtake this level. In this case, new target could be 1.15. Otherwise, if the market will go under this level, we have a clear target around 1.10, 1.0980. That is more or less the previous resistance now support. So this is for what concerning the situation of the euro dollar. But let's see also another interesting exchange rate, that is the cable. So euro dollar against the GBP pound against the euro dollar. Okay, so it's easy to see that we have a clear support here around 1.22. This is quite relevant. Sometimes it worked at this resistance, but now the new one is 1.28. That has not only this recent target, but also a very old history here in the previous year. So the situation is that in the middle of this, we have something like a middle lane that is 1.24 that work as a support. So in this moment, it seems we will see again something like this first target or next 1.28. Otherwise, in case of movement down here, we will see 1.22, but it seems this second one to be the more interesting. So let's also compare the dollar with some other different currencies, for example, like the Canadian dollar, and we will easily see that the situation here is that we have something like a box here, box with two levels. One is this one, the support, and the resistance is more or less this one. So let's see where the market will exit the support or the resistance, or will exit the box in short term. Again, we can see the dollar compared with the Australian dollar, so quite a similar situation, a little inverted because of the currency pair structure, but 0.68 works as a support here, and 0.7 we can say it's a resistance. More or less, we are moving inside this level. The next interesting movement will be while exiting this situation that we can expect. Again, we can look at the New Zealand dollar against the US dollar, and again we have a very similar situation. It's very clear that we have a box here that is 0.64. Here we are, and we have here 0.65 as intermediate resistance, and then a little bit less than 0.66 as the short-term target of the figure. So more or less, this is the situation connected to the dollar. But very important things are coming from the commodities that we are now going to analyze. This is the crude oil. Crude oil tried to overtake the previous maximum, not able to close over this level, always coming back at the end of the day, but for sure area 40, 40.4, this is more or less from 40 to 41, we can say it's the resistance. In case of overtaking the resistance, we can easily see that this area between $48 and $50 can become the next very important resistance, but this is still something to do. We have here clearly a support around $35-$44 per barrel. In case of violation of it, because it seems that we are now more or less in this kind of sideway, But let's see what will happen. In case of breakout of this level, the next support will be, in my opinion, around $28 per barrel. So more or less, this is what I expect from the market. But very interesting seems to be the situation connected to the gold. After some months, after more than 2 months, the gold was between 1,675 and 1,775. So more or less up and down $100 per ounce. We have seen now in the last 2-3 days that the gold was very strong, and it seems that now the box is gone. We have seen a breakout. Let's see how it will go, but it seemed to be a clear breakout. We are now looking at a new maximum period, a maximum of a big period, okay? So let's say that the first target could be 1,800, but probably all this figure as a more interesting target. Let's see in the future. So this is really, really very interesting. And let me say another very interesting chart is the silver, because the silver is again very close to the resistance of intermediate resistance, this one, okay? But let's assume that we hope to see it again at 19, especially if the gold will be able to grow up after this breakout that we have seen live a few minutes ago. So this is very interesting situation. So let's switch from the commodities to the stock indices. Stock indices are really interesting because starting from the Nasdaq, we could see that here we are, that we had yesterday a new highest closing maximum of a day, over 10,150. So this is very interesting. Well, it's really strong, the movement that we have seen. We supposed in the very beginning to see a V formation, but this is even more than a V formation. This is really new historical maximum, and this is the most performing, let me say, Western indices. Let me even if we remain in the United States, and we switch to the S&P 500, we can see that this is not the same, okay? So we have here something that is a good reaction, but not a V formation, a precise V formation. And the S&P 500 is very similar to the DAX. So this is really interesting. This is the DAX, okay? And very similar if we compare it to the S&P 500. Considering the DAX, it seemed yesterday that we had the possibility to do a breakout of a box of the last five trading days. But today, the situation was completely canceled. So right now, we can say that we are still in the previous box. So we have a minimum around 12,000 and something, 12,100. So this is the minimum, and we have already seen the maximum here. A very similar situation we have on the Eurostock 50. The Eurostock 50 is really very similar in the behavior, very similar than the DAX. And here we have a clear box, nothing to do yesterday with the possibility to do the breakout. This is 3,300 here, and we have more or less 3,180 something around here on this level. And last, I want to show you the situation on the Italian index that is quite similar than the Eurostock 50. So we have seen 19,900, that is this maximum, okay, and we were very close to it in the morning today at the opening bell, and we have 19,200, that is a support. So we are 200 points far from the support here. Let's see what is going to happen in the next incoming trading session. So the situation seems to be that on the stock indices, we are now pausing, waiting for some additional movement yet to come. except for the Nasdaq that is still growing and growing and growing. So for those concerning the commodities, we had a very good movement. The crude oil tried to overtake the previous maximum, but was unable finally to do that for the moment. On the other side, we have the gold that is breaking out a two-month box, and this two-month box, so this is a quite interesting situation because the space to move over there, okay? Exactly good is the silver from the side of currencies. It seems to be a waiting market after the movement, after the dollar was weaker than the other currencies. Now it's the situation is with more equilibrium, okay? And we will see in the next session what is going to happen. So this is all for the midweek appointment from Italy. Ciao, ciao from Davide Biocchi. See you soon. Ciao.